Hi 10th standard students, while you are listening to my audio lectures, kindly go through your textbook and diagrams in your textbook. It will be easy for you to get the concept what I am going to teach you. Okay, today we are going to learn about the vascular tissue system. It consists of xylem and phloem tissues. Vascular tissue system consists of xylem and phloem tissues. They are present in the form of bundles called vascular bundles. As these vascular tissues, xylem and phloem, are in the form of bundles, hence it is called as vascular bundles. Xylem conducts water and minerals to different parts of the plant. Phloem conducts food materials to different parts of the plant. So what is the function of xylem and phloem? Xylem conducts water and minerals to different parts of the plant, while phloem conducts food materials to different parts of the plant. Three different types of vascular bundles are there. What are they? Radial, conjoint and concentric. So three different types of vascular bundles, they are radial, conjoint and concentric. So you know why these vascular tissue system are called as vascular bundles? As they are present in the form of a bundles, hence it is called as vascular bundles. Three types of vascular bundles are there. What are they? Radial, conjoint and concentric. First, we are going to learn about the radial vascular bundles. Xylem and phloem are present in different radii alternating with each other. Example, roots. So, in radial vascular bundle, the xylem and phloem are present in different radii alternating with each other. So, you can see in that diagram, it is present in different radii. That is, if one row of xylem is present, next phloem, then phloem. So, here the xylem and phloem are present in different radii alternating with each other. Example, roots. Second type of vascular bundles are conjoint vascular bundles. Xylem and phloem lie on the same radius. There are two types of conjoint vascular bundles. So, radial vascular bundles where xylem and phloem are present in different radii. In conjoint, xylem and phloem lie on the same radius. There are two types of conjoint vascular bundles. They are collateral and bicollateral. So, two types of conjoint vascular bundles, they are collateral and bicollateral. So, first we are going to learn about the collateral. Xylem lies towards the center and phloem lies towards the periphery. So, in collateral vascular bundles, what is the point? Xylem lies towards the center and phloem lies towards the periphery. So, you know, as they are present on the same radius and xylem lies towards the center and phloem lies towards the periphery. When cambium is present in collateral vascular bundle, it is called open. So, in this diagram, you can see in between the xylem and phloem, a row of cambium is present. Some extra cells are present in between the xylem and the phloem. If cambium is present in between the xylem and phloem, it is called open. Example, dicot stem. And collateral bundle without cambium is called closed. So, if cambium is not present in between the xylem and phloem, it is called as closed. Example, monocot stem. So, collateral, I will explain it again. Xylem lies towards the center and phloem lies towards the periphery. If cambium is present between the xylem and phloem, it is called open. If it is absent, if the cambium is absent between the xylem and phloem, it is called closed. So, second type of conjoint vascular bundle is the bicollateral. In this type of vascular bundle, the phloem is present on both outer and inner side of xylem. So, bicollateral. In this type of bundle, The phloem is present on both outer and inner side of the xylem. Imagine xylem is present at the center, where phloem is present in both sides of the xylem. Where xylem is present at the center and both sides, it consists of outer and inner phloem. So here, what is bicollateral? In this type of bundle, the phloem is present on both outer and inner side of xylem. Third type of vascular bundle is concentric vascular bundle. So you should remember three types of vascular bundles. What are they? Radial, conjoint and concentric vascular bundles, where conjoint vascular bundles are divided into two. What are they? Collateral and bicollateral. Third type is the concentric vascular bundles. Vascular bundle in which xylem completely surrounds the phloem or vice versa is called concentric vascular bundle. It is of two types, amphiversal and amphicribral. So imagine in concentric vascular bundle, if xylem is present at the center, it is surrounded by the phloem. Or if phloem is present at the center, it is surrounded by the xylem. So what is concentric vascular bundle? Vascular bundle in which xylem completely surrounds the phloem or vice versa is called concentric vascular bundle. Two types of concentric vascular bundles are there. They are amphivasal and amphicribral. In amphivasal, where the phloem is present at the center, it is surrounded by xylem. In amphivasal, phloem is present at the center, it is surrounded by xylem. Second type is the amphicribral, where the xylem is present at the center, it is surrounded by the phloem. What is amphicribral? Xylem is present at the center, it is surrounded by the phloem. Hope you understand radial, conjoint and concentric vascular bundles. Two more additional points are there, end arch and exarch. End arch, protoxylem lies towards the center and metaxylem lies towards the periphery. So check the diagram of radial vascular bundle, where you can see xylem and phloem. Look at the diagram of the xylem, where you can see xylem smallest cells are present at the periphery. You know, in a circle, you know the periphery and the center. The middle is the center and the outline is the periphery. Okay, so here protoxylem means in the xylem, the smallest xylem is the protoxylem and the largest xylem is the metaxylem. Clear? Smallest xylem is the protoxylem and the largest xylem is the metaxylem. Now, what is end arch? Protoxylem lies towards the center and the metaxylem lies towards the periphery. Example, stem. So what is end arch? Protoxylem lies towards the center, that is the smallest xylem lies towards the center and the metaxylem, largest xylem, lies towards the periphery. What is exarch? Protoxylem lies towards the periphery and metaxylem lies towards the center. What is exarch? Protoxylem lies towards the periphery. So you know protoxylem, it is the smallest xylem. So you know the meaning of ex and end. Ex means outside, end means, endo means inside. Okay, so here exarch means protoxylem, that is the smallest xylem, lies towards the periphery, that is the outline of the vascular bundle, and the metaxylem lies towards the center. You can see in this diagram also, where the metaxylem is lying towards the center. Okay, what is the example? Roots. So what is end arch and exarch? In end arch, the protoxylem lies towards the center and metaxylem lies towards the periphery. Example, stem. Exarch, protoxylem lies towards the periphery and metaxylem lies towards the center.